coming up next week or the week after, and it's probably the case that there will be further cuts. So it is an issue in relation to this, but it's also an issue in relation to socialisation, access to schools, access to libraries. It is an issue for the borough, and it is something that this whole council should be shouting to the city region and the Metro Mayor, sort this out, because it's a problem for us all. And I want to say that. I will ask if you would direct me to write again, or ask the leader of the council to write again to the Metro Mayor to say, get a grip of what's happening to bus services on the Wirral. I know it's happening on the Wirral side of the water as well, but I live on the Wirral, and I'm more concerned about the Wirral.
Chair, can we have a date for the next transport group that you allude to? When's that going to meet?
I don't have the date, but we can get that for you.
Sorry, Chair. I remember you making a statement at a previous committee around transport, and clearly we all need to work together as part of the local plan around this as well. I've just actually found the minutes of the Joint Strategic Commission Board on the 9th of July 2019. I can confirm that the decision was made as a result of public consultation by the NHS Wirral CCG governing body. So it's held within the JSCB because the JSCB is a meeting of the public and is filmed, but the public consultation that was approved by the NHS Wirral CCG governing body and not by the JSCB.
I'm ready to move on if we're happy to do that. Can I make two recommendations? The first is that everything will become operational in April, right? Apart from the interim urgent care treatment centre, which came into stream on the 19th of December. So we have a progress report in September, if you don't mind, on how things are being coped with, what the provision is adequate to meet the demand. In the development plans in particular, but elsewhere as well. And can I have your permission to write, ask the leader of the council again to write to the Metro Mayor to say resist strongly, please, any further cuts to buses on the Wirral, and look at reinstating the buses that were served at the hospital that came from the far out regions of Wirral, which has been taken out.
I certainly welcome that. I'm happy to support you.
Well, it would actually look quite strong if we could have your signatures to the letter.
More than happy to do that, Councillor.
I think that might be a better way to put it.
Chair, can I just say, how, when we move on to a committee system rather than a cabinet system, will that affect this reporting mechanism?
Well, we did some work last night. I mean, I don't want to go into the detail about the cabinet. What we discussed last night, because it will come to your roots and what have you, but there will be provision within the committee system. I do believe the committees will have more weight than the scrutiny committee, but that is the decision making, aren't they, when they aren't decision making. So I do believe it will have more weight. But it would be good to have a signature from yourselves on that letter. It may well be, but at this stage it will come from me rather than the leader of the council and the party spokes as well. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Can I redirect that and say instead of asking the leader of the council that we have it from the party spokes and myself as chair, and that we can't be to the okay.
I had scribbled an idea down based on the discussion that took place, and clearly what we've moved with fitting with this. I scribbled, the committee welcomes the progress report and details on the extent of the preparations, appreciates the attention being given to planning services, requests additional information on the geographical distribution of and take-up of the additional GP appointments, still remains very concerned about the lack of transport to existing and proposed services, and urges close cooperation between all bodies in the future planning associated with the local plan and expected population growth.
I'm sure that the committee is happy to support that. Okay, so we accept that. Thank you. We're up to agenda item 8 now, and this is really just for noting, unless anybody has any queries over the accuracy of the way the report is constructed, the content of the report, but it reflects the workshop that was held
a difference of opinion as to effectiveness of integration and how we support the budget at that meeting. But this, I must be just to note that this is an accurate reflection of what happened at that workshop. So that's pretty much formally happy to do that. And it will now go through to the Joint Strategic Commissioning Board. Okay? And then we're on to the work programme, which is agenda item 9. And it is as it stands, but I think there's a couple of things that I'd like to highlight. At the last meeting, we had the annual public health report, and we made the comment then that we would like to see on the agenda specific topics that public health has responsibility for, or has input into, we can't take responsibility for, such as housing, levels of obesity, care quality, vaccination rates, dental hygiene, factors influencing the difference in mortality rates in different sites of the borough. So we'll add those to the work programme. I start by asking you, at the next committee meeting, I think we did identify housing as the first one we'd like to look at. So can we have a report on the public health perspective on housing in the borough? And to be a little bit more specific, the quality of the housing, the availability of housing is at a cost that people can afford, and particularly looking at the quality of the private rental market. Can we have that, please? And then, out of what's happened tonight, can I suggest that we have the County Lines workshop as soon as we've arranged that, and that should be for the beginning of April, before people get busy doing other things, which I won't be doing, but there we go. And also, we had a report on the, after we've had the workshop on modern slavery, can we have a report on what action has been taken in Wirral specifically to identify areas where we know that there's, they have found that there are people working who are not being properly employed and would be classed as coming into that category of modern day slavery, and what action has been taken about specifically about people who are employing people in that way or using people in that way, and a very detailed report on figures, on some figures, because I don't think, and I may be wrong, but I don't know if there's been any prosecutions at all so far. I may be wrong. Yes, Catherine.
Chair, but when we did the just to finish on human trafficking,
it was a while ago, though, wasn't it?
Yeah, but there's been two updates since.
Not come to this committee, though.
I don't know what committee's all up to. But what I'm trying to say, if I may finish, is that there were prosecutions and there were ongoing inquiries, and it does appear to be working in some degree. But that's only the ones you have referred to are the obvious ones. It's the hidden ones that are still presenting the problems, that I understand it.
Okay, and if that concludes the business. Sorry,
can I have another room? I was surprised to be out of the room. Did you mention the 5G?
It's on the work programme, isn't it?
Yeah.
Didn't mention it specifically tonight because I wasn't using it as an addition. I didn't go through the whole work programme. I just mentioned tonight things that I wanted to. I saw it there.
Just aware that the questions asked the full council.
It's early 2019, so we will get on the agenda. It's down there.
Thank you.